What's going on, guys? Welcome to Garage 23. And today we're taking a little bit of a break from the S14 project to fix another CD09. This one actually has a broken first gear. So we're going to be fixing that, since that was something that wasn't included in our initial CD09 repair videos. So come check it out. Okay, so obviously we already have this one pretty much all the way disassembled. If you need to know how to take it apart from the very beginning, it's gonna be in our first video, linked up here. Yeah, so this one, it was kind of doing the same thing that ours was doing when we first got it, which was that it wouldn't spin in gear. And this was actually the very first CD09 I ever took apart. Not all the way like this, but like, the first one I ever took the case off of and got to see like the insides and stuff. And I did it with my buddy Juan. And like I said, it was the first one that I've ever taken apart or taken a look at inside, and we had no idea what we were looking at.
Nani?
I mean, it all looked like gears and stuff. We mainly opened it because we thought that something was broken, right? So if your first gear or something, or if the transmission isn't spinning, you're kind of expecting something to be in pieces. So we took it apart just to check for that, and everything looked pretty much fine. And so we're like, I don't know. He was originally gonna take it to a shop to have them fix it. And just like many of you probably know, most shops won't even touch these. They're just like,
go get a new one.
And if they do want to touch it, they'll charge you like $3,000 or something. And what's the point of that when a brand new one from Nissan is like $2,000? So it's very counterproductive, and usually these end up in the trash if they're broken, which is where we come in and teach you how to fix them. I got everything taken apart and I checked the individual gears, and I finally found it that it was first gear that was binding to the shaft. So similar to how our third gear was broken and stuck against the counter shaft, this first gear was stuck against the main shaft. So I started using the press and taking everything apart, which for the main shaft we hadn't done before. So I have everything back in the order that we took it apart to kind of show you guys. Initially, I just put this in the press here and pushed this way. So I pushed all this and pressed it out. And so we got our, I think second gear? No, third gear. Anyway, and then this sleeve is just kind of sitting there. Against these, it's further down here. Obviously this isn't pressed together now, but all these gears go up against here. So this sleeve just kind of sits against all this other stuff down here. It just sits there like that. But from there, I pressed, this gear was right up against our first gear. So this one right here is our main issue, is our first gear. And I put it in the press against our first and pressed this out. And so these two were coming out together, and so they came out like that. And this is your bearing for first gear, and so those came out like this. And then you were left with just the bare shaft and your synchro hub. And this is the replacement that I already have in here, but the one that was in there is this one. And what I found super interesting is that this was like deformed and like wedged together. And so that explained why first gear was locked up, is because all this was just crammed together. And you can see the amount of force that this thing took to just deform the brass that way on all the little teeth here. That one's particularly bad. And same thing. So there was that. And then, so I thought maybe I could get away with just switching the, because there's a set of three teeth, I guess you'd call them. So initially I thought maybe I could just spin this around to have it sit on the less damaged ones, but then if you check the inside of the synchro, I mean, it is just totally fried. like all the materials just ground away. And it's even as far as getting embedded into the iron center ring. So all that is our synchro on the outside and on the inside. So needless to say, this thing is just garbage. So we got our replacement and it's nice and shiny and perfect and brand new. Again, we got this from the same supplier in Japan, Amayama, which we'll link down below. You guys can get any, pretty much any Nissan part that you have a part number for, and they'll ship it overseas to us for a fraction of the price. To give you an example, this same synchro Z1 Motorsports sells for $270. We paid $60 for this shipped overseas from Japan. I don't understand why it's that way. It's just stupid. And I guarantee you a lot more of these wouldn't be in the trash if they would just charge us the appropriate amount. Because keep in mind, if Nissan Japan is selling this for $60, this probably cost them, what, $30 to make? And the US stores are charging $270? That is an absurd markup. Anyway. So yeah, this one's pretty much ready to go in. It's got some oil already smeared all over it. And this mates up to our first gear. And our first gear even shows a little bit of, I wouldn't say damage, but it's got a bunch of brass smeared all over it too. I don't think that's gonna, I mean, you can't even feel it. So I don't think it's gonna be any issue or anything. But yeah, our synchro sits here like this. And then those four prongs on the iron ring sit in these grooves like that. And that's pretty much it. And it slides back onto your main shaft. Just like so. Just gotta line it up. Like that. Yeah. First, second, and that's ready to be put back together. So now what we're gonna do is just press all this stuff back together. This is, on this end is our fifth gear, sixth gear. And I only pressed this off because I thought that's how you got this assembly off, but it doesn't come off this way, it comes off that way. So that's one thing to keep in mind. You don't have to take any of this apart, but I already did, so oh well. All right, so this part's gonna be kind of tricky because all this stuff here is still loose, but we need to put it upside down to press it into the next gear, which is our third gear. So I think I'm basically just gonna have to hold it. So this one, your third gear has two sides. One side's pretty much flat. The other side has this like recess. The flat side is what goes against your first gear. So we're gonna set that down like that. And then try not to let that fall out everywhere. Jeez. Spacer just sits there like that. And then our fourth gear, which I had some trouble trying to figure out which way it goes because the service manual doesn't specify which direction it gets pressed in, because one side has a lip and the other side, I mean, they both have a lip, but one sticks out more than the other. The other side's basically flat. And judging from our first videos, from what I could tell, the flat side goes against the spacer, so it should go in there like this. So now we press this guy. Okay, next up is gonna be our main shaft bearing. And this one's also directional because it has the groove for the snap ring that goes into your mid plate. And this groove needs to face toward the tail shaft. So, there, like that.
Oh no.
I don't know what happened, but it works now.
Okay. What does it sound like?
Ooh. Okay, last thing is gonna be our bearing race, I guess, for our reverse gear. And that goes at the end of everything. But I don't think this is gonna fit in here now. Yeah, so we're gonna have to move everything around. Now, for the stuff I wasn't supposed to take apart. Okay, this is our sixth gear and fifth and sixth synchro hub. And this one has a two-piece inner bearing, so you gotta be careful with this one and basically install this one first. So you put both halves in that way, then gear goes over the bearing like that, and then our hub goes on top of that. All right, so we had to switch to the scrap metal because the socket was starting to hit the grooves, so it wasn't going to press the hub down all the way. And you just want to make sure that there's a groove here in these teeth for the snap ring. And you want to make sure that the hub is flush with the groove there, which I think ours is. We need a little bit more. Yeah, I'm just gonna get a couple more. Okay, now we can try to get this snap ring back on. I think that looks good. The spacer that goes here, and then these larger needle bearings, which is what our input shaft and fifth gear ride on, like that. And that is our complete main shaft, which if we did everything right, should mate up to our counter shaft, like that. That is pretty much it. Now all that's left is just our general reassembly. And you can watch our other videos for that, because this is pretty much done. I guess the only other thing that we haven't covered on these is second gear, which is basically the same process as we did here, but you would just need to keep disassembling a little more. I mean, there was only one step left to get our main shaft completely disassembled, and that was the second gear. So you would have just put your main shaft back in the press and taken that second gear off, just like everything else that we had taken off, and replace whatever you needed to there. So it was pretty much the same process as we did here. So nothing too complicated, but yeah, time to get this thing back together and see if she runs. See you guys next time.